Nowadays, if you want to get in shape, you don't go jogging. You sign up for an extreme fitness boot camp. Sergeant Stu's water torture class was one of the most abusive.
You guys stink!
The only time I would think it would be dangerous for a client to be trained by a personal trainer is when the personal trainer does not know what he's doing. However, an expert like myself, me pushing them beyond their physical capabilities, that isn't dangerous at all. Yes, my clients puke. However, that's just their body adapting to change, something they're not used to.
One of Sergeant Stu's favorite torture techniques, he'd jack up the thermostat on the pool's heater to double the suffering index.
It's a freaking hot tub in here.
It is not. The water's fine. This is an attitude problem.
Sergeant Sadist decided this girl's class was getting too whiny, so he decided to show them how it's done.
We are going to have an endurance race. If any one of you win, we're done for the day. Ready? Set! Go!
Stu got out to a quick start. But after a few laps, the girls left him in their wake. 20 laps later, the exhausted booty campers crawled out of the pool. But where was Stu? He was doing a good impression of a goldfish, the kind you wind up flushing down the toilet.
During exercise, 70% of energy goes towards cooling down the muscles as sweat. In a pool that is 80 degrees or higher, the skin doesn't have the ability to cool itself down. He experienced hyperthermia, more commonly known as heat stroke.
Stu's decision to wear a full body swimsuit caused him to retain heat and go into hyperthermia even quicker. His brain overheated and threw his heart into overdrive. His students didn't notice he was dying until he was dead.
Give me 50.
Let this be a lesson for all you fitness freaks. Take it slow.
You guys are terrible.
And easy.
Go.
Or you might wind up like Stu, dead in the water.